welcome to this DrChrono virtual lesson. We have some big changes underway for the DrChrono EHR app, and we want our customers to be ready for when we do make these changes. We know that it'll take a little bit of time to get familiar with the new design, but we're confident that this is a huge step forward for DrChrono, and we're excited to launch our newest design. So here's the homepage. You can immediately see some key differences, but there's also a lot of similarities to previous versions. For example, the hamburger menu at the top right corner is gone, but the schedule panel on the left is virtually untouched. So let's start with the biggest change, the hamburger menu. Previously, you had to click an icon with three little lines in the top right corner to access different parts of the EHR. Well, we've gotten rid of that hidden menu and replaced it with an easy access menu at the bottom of the screen. Here, you can access your dashboard, the home page, the message center, tasks, and your account settings. I'm going to focus on the EHR button, the home page, and the account settings button, as those two pages have changed quite a bit in this update. The account button takes you to your account setting, but also allows you access to features such as chat, the template library, and the meaningful use report. You can also submit a ticket through the help button here. And this is where you can find the option to lock the app or log out completely. Back to the home page, you'll notice where the hamburger button used to be, there's now a plus sign. If you click it, you have a few options such as creating a new appointment, a new patient, taking a clinical photo, or logging a phone call. To the left of the plus sign is a magnifying glass. You can search for existing patients here. You can also see your list of recent appointments you visited here. That leaves us with the patient's info sheet here. As you can see, there's a lot more information on this initial page than on the previous version. You can even scroll down to see more information about this patient and their visit. The most important thing to take away from this video is that everything that is in blue text is expandable with a click. This includes the patient name here at the top. Here you'll find quite a list of views and actions you can take with this particular patient. The idea being that we want you to be able to access information from anywhere in the app, not just when you click Start Visit. So without going to the patient chart directly, I can prescribe a medication by clicking Send ERX. You'll notice when I do that, it shows me that there are some drafts for Rizzo that I haven't sent out. I can click New ERX or View Drafts. When I'm done sending medication, I can click his name again and send a referral. There's a lot of different things to do from this list, but they all function like the previous app versions. We just made it more accessible across the app. We welcome you to check them all out so you can be familiar with our new streamlined design. The Start Visit button takes you to the familiar chart section of the app. This section will also be getting a facelift in the future, but we wanted these changes to be gradual. You'll see, however, I can still click Rizzo's name and see the list of views and actions that appeared on the homepage. That about wraps up the first release of this new design. We know change can take some adjusting, and if you have any questions at all, please let us know by submitting a ticket through the app or going to drchrono.com/help.